Hello, I'm Dr. David Levien, President and CEO of the American College of Healthcare Trustees. We were founded 7 years ago to support good governance, good leadership, and good decision making in healthcare. We do that by virtue of conferences and remote learning, as well as networking, consulting, and curated services. Our curriculum is multifaceted and includes quality and safety, governance, bioethics, health law and compliance, and technology and healthcare, human resources, and more. We call our members fellows, and they include board directors, healthcare executives, surgeons, physicians and nurses, innovators and visionaries and startups, healthcare attorneys, quality and safety experts, compliance experts, data scientists, engineers, ethicists, theologians, and concerned lay people who wish to improve the patient experience and healthcare in general. The facet of our curriculum addressed today is ethics. You can tell a lot about an organization's core values by its capital budget process, where it spends its money. Our instructor today is Dr. Carl Middleton, who is Senior Vice President for Ethics and Chief Operating Officer at the American College of Healthcare Trustees and a member of our Board of Directors. He has been a theologian and ethicist for over 40 years in Catholic healthcare. Dr. Middleton also has an extensive work record, including teaching ethics in a Catholic seminary, in nursing schools, in medical residencies, and serving as Director of Pastoral Care, Vice President for Human Educational Services, Corporate Director of Values, Ethics, and Ministry. He is an expert on discernment, pain management, capital budgeting, retreat planning, conflict resolution, and a host of other administrative issues. We are very fortunate to have Dr. Middleton on our board of directors and giving this conference today.
For capital allocation decisions, ethical reflection and value-based criteria have important roles in the moral life and decisions of individuals. A person's values influences his or her actions. It is equally true that ethical reflection and the development of value-based criteria of action are central for organizations and moral agents. An organization is not one human being, but a community of a number of human beings. Therefore, a consensus is needed for an organization to confront ethical issues, choose among alternatives and courses of action. Organizations dedicated to ethical decision-making will develop value-based criteria for setting purposes and priorities, writing policy, and strive for consistent implementation at various levels of leadership. Welcome to the world of organizational ethics. Organizational ethics is the study of ethical issues associated with the systems, structures, and processes that shape encounters between healthcare providers and patients in hospitals, residents in long-term care facilities, and clients in behavioral settings. It is a disciplined process for incorporating ethical reflection and practices into the life and work of an organization. It is usually the executive leadership team that make an important number of ethical decisions regarding the organization. For example, the annual budget and the strategic plan would be two significant ethical decisions. One major ethical decision is the allocation of limited financial resources. Ideally, the allocation of capital and other forms of financial resources should be based on a healthcare organization's core values, such as integrity, concern for others, safety, quality, compassion, and excellence. What we are about today is to apply the concepts and methods of ethical reflection and discernment to allocating limited capital dollars for the support of our vital work in healthcare. If a healthcare organization does not have a method of ethical decision-making, the capital allocation process could be reduced to, you scratch my back this year, and I'll scratch yours next year. Without an ethical process, capital allocation is often reduced to backroom and hallway negotiations, with usually the squeaky wheel getting the most grease. In my opinion, there are three categories of reflection questions that hopefully will assist us in determining how we should allocate capital dollars that is most consistent with our healthcare mission, vision, and core values, and determining the greatest need. The reflection categories are legitimate organizational self-interest, multiple responsibilities to stakeholders, and social vision and social responsibility. Each of these categories are two-dimensional and must be considered as interrelational. Each category may be applied to a particular healthcare organization or to a healthcare system as a whole. Let us now examine each of these categories and pose some questions for your reflection and discernment to use in capital allocation decisions. So, legitimate organizational self-interest. One of the most basic and pervasive ethical perspectives shaping an organization is the self-interest of that organization. Most often, self-interest is expressed in terms of the priority of revenue, productivity, survival, and growth. A mission-driven and values-based organization can't serve if it doesn't survive, and therefore, there is an important interrelationship between mission and margin. Self-interest is a valid element in human ethics and viewed in relation to other perspectives and purposes, and is a crucial component of comprehensive ethical decision-making. For example, Jesus taught us to love God with our whole heart, mind, and soul, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. A healthcare organization's mission, vision, and core values of person-centered care, quality, safety, compassion, and excellence, and respect for persons are important core values and most relevant to ethical discernment in this process. We not only respect others, but ourselves and our mission. Important in any healthcare organization's culture, stewardship is a critical behavioral attribute of person-centered care. Stewardship is the careful use of resources, time, human, financial, and environmental in order to fulfill our mission. Excellence and its behavioral attribute of continuous improvement are continuously striving to provide quality and safe care in an effective and productive manner. These core values of a healthcare organization are essential to a facility or system's survival and viability. It is essential to remember that legitimate self-interest refers to both the local facility as well as legitimate self-interest for the healthcare system as a whole. Now, for reflection questions. To what degree does this alternative investment or purchase contribute to a legitimate self-interest of the local facility, the legitimate self-interest of the healthcare system? To what degree will this investment expenditure increase our revenue or return on investment, productivity, and growth? Multiple responsibilities to stakeholders. Category number two. The relationships between an organization and the many groups affected by its services and actions involve value judgments and ethical reflection. One way to formulate multiple responsibilities is through the concept of stakeholder. R. Edward Freeman, in his book, Stakeholder Theory, The State of the Art, writes, simply put, a stakeholder is any group or individuals who can affect or is affected by the achievement of a corporation's purposes. For a healthcare organization, its stakeholders usually include the board, physicians, employees, volunteers, residents, fellows, suppliers, the local community, as well as the entire healthcare system. The first task of the ethics of multiple responsibility is to identify the various groups who are recognized as having a stake in our mission. The second task is to identify the needs of the various stakeholders, which includes needs for capital dollars. Objectively assessing and prioritizing the stakeholders' capital needs is the third task. The needs assessment analysis and prioritization of tasks are usually accomplished and precede the ethical discernment process. A healthcare organization's core values such as person-centered care and integrity have application here. Each core value should be spelled out with behavioral attributes for each core value. The specific behavioral attributes for person-centered care would be respect, dignity, collaborative spirit, concern for safety and quality. Behavioral attributes for integrity could be honesty, transparency, open communication, humility, and ethics integration. So, reflection question. To what degree will this alternative or capital allocation enhance key strategic relationships with our stakeholders? Have we objectively assessed, analyzed, and prioritized the needs of the stakeholders at the healthcare facility level and within the healthcare system? A third category is social vision and social responsibility. A third perspective from which to understand the ethics of corporate action concerns the ways in which plans are projected, results are evaluated, and the future of society and common good is envisioned. The ethics of social vision is present in corporations and represents leadership's acceptance of the obligation to adopt a long-range perspective on society, which includes local, national, and global, that identifies specific social problems and strategic plans that will move us from where we are now toward a more humane and peaceful world, also known as corporate social responsibilities. And I quote, "Corporate social responsibility is a self-regulating business model that helps a company be socially accountable to itself, its stakeholders, and the public. By practicing corporate social responsibility, also known as corporate citizenship, companies can be conscious of the kind of impact they're having on all aspects of society, including economic, social, and environmental. To engage in corporate social responsibility means that in the ordinary course of business, a company is operating in ways that enhance society and the environment instead of contributing negatively to them." End of quote. And this is from Corporate Social Responsibility by Jason Fernando and Gordon Scott. For a healthcare system or its local facilities, this social vision and healthcare's core values of compassion include specific contribution to the common good through striving to develop healthier communities, efforts to care for the poor and marginalized, contributing to global and international mission activities, and working to improve access for those who are uninsured and underinsured. The behavioral attributes of strategic focus, accountability, and innovation have specific application in this regard. It is not so much a question as to whether social vision and compassion will be present in our corporate world, but rather the extent to which such vision is self-consciously developed, deliberately discussed, and critically integrated into our budgeting and allocation processes. Reflection question. To what degree will this decision or allocation affect our commitment to social vision of enhancing the wellness of our community? To what degree will it enable us to provide more affordable and accessible healthcare for the common good of our service area. How will this allocation contribute to creating healthier communities? How will this decision impact our care of persons who are poor and impact community benefit? And how will the decision or allocation impact the common good of the local facility and the common good of the healthcare system? There obviously will be conflicts and robust conversation, and it's not choosing one of these categories to the exclusion of the other. The challenge is to be able to balance all three of these categories. There's a need for, and to be able to do this, there's a need for an experienced facilitator who can effectively manage these conflicts that will arise as we attempt to discuss allocation resources, and not necessarily should it involve someone from the executive leadership team. Most effective is an experienced external facilitator who, as they say, has no skin in the game. So in summary, these three categories are interrelated and we strive to satisfy all of them in some way. In light of these three categories, it might be helpful to ask three following questions of each opinion or alternative or the amount of dollars allocated to specific projects being considered. To what degree does this alternative or investment contribute to our legitimate self-interest? To what degree will this alternative enhance key strategic relationships with our stakeholders, strategic partners, and local community? And to what degree will this enhance our commitment to social vision and enhancing the wellness of the community we are called to serve? Thank you for participating in this course.
We want to thank Dr. Middleton for his outstanding work. Participants in this course can get 1 hour ACHT credit towards blue, brown, or black belts in bioethics, health law, and compliance, and credit towards designations of ACHT Fellow with Special Merit and Fellow with Distinction. To get the credit, one needs to watch this short video, read the PDF in the document section of our website, accessible from the black menu on our homepage, and complete the short quiz and course evaluation. You can also claim hour-for-hour credits for posting comments on any of our blogs.